Very interesting game. Well, people who would look at it quickly in the evening would think probably, well, nothing really happened. They shuffled the piece, put it on the other side, and well, they even eventually agreed to draw. But in fact, having a look at it also with Peter Lecco, who is extremely strong and understands all subtleties of chess and of your game as well. I mean, we managed to enter the game very deeply. So what were your impressions in this game? Maybe Magnus is white.
Well, first of all, I tried to be a little bit clever in the opening, which was not a good idea because I felt that, yeah, as soon as we get this position, he gets a4. I think really black is the only one who can be slightly better. So at this point, I wasn't feeling so great, but still it's an interesting position. Lots of nuances for both sides, and I think the way I played, I managed to keep decent chances.
So there was this move Bishop G4, which you
like
played after quite a long think, and was maybe not so easy to meet, Levon.
Well, I was. Yeah, I underestimated this move. I was very happy. I thought white has to play Qc2, but Qc2 is a bad move, certainly. I'm just slightly better here. So, Bishop G4, somehow I thought that F5, Bishop H3, Queen F7, but Knight D2, and Knight C4 is coming, so it's...
Knight G5 maybe is
also Knight
even...
Knight G5 and
G4
is
yes.
Also possible.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, this?
Yes,
even this
looks
one.
Very strong. Knight
oh,
G6,
okay.
I don't know
E4.
About very strong, but...
We are supported by the machine before.
We
don't see it now.
Taken Bishop D6, F4. Aha, aha. Okay, that's too many tactical things for me. Yeah. So, yeah. Anyway, I mean, to illustrate the amount of chippos in the position, I have to say that my intention when I played Bishop D6 was to play Knight D7. You know, on move number 16.
So here, instead
yeah.
of bishop...
But actually... No, no.
After bishop b6.
But
right.
actually, knight d7 here doesn't work, so b6.
Oh.
Yeah.
And the knight
Otherwise,
is coming to
knight d7 looks brilliant, you know. Knight comes to c5
mm-hmm.
and everything works. So... And bishop g4 was a good move. I had to play queen d8, of course.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Because... Yeah.
Yeah.
But here the position is not easy to understand.
I thought for a long time also after queen d8 because... it's really not a position where there. I mean, I'm happy to have forced this queen to the eight, but still, it's not at all obvious what my next move is going to be.
Mm-hmm.
So
when you played bishop c3, we thought your idea was to play
queen
b2 afterwards.
Yeah, something like that, but basically.
B6.
I
was planning to move.
Yeah, no, but here I didn't see the point of queen b2 to be on.
Mm-hmm.
To be honest, it just seems that. I mean, bishop c3 was more of a defensive idea in order to prevent rook a5 than anything else.
So now you would like to play bishop b4 in this position?
Maybe I can even
but you can
take twice.
Take
on e4, take on b4.
Take on e4 first?
I wasn't sure about those things.
Yeah, here we tried some
exchange
sec, but it's maybe just equal.
What did we try already?
Queen before knight c5.
That's
this one we tried.
We tried,
we
but it looks completely equal.
Enough, but not for being better. And pawn takes.
Pawn takes knight f6.
Yes.
Dangerous for white.
But if I maybe I can take on d7 before.
At what point exactly?
After bishop b4, bishop e4, take on d7.
Yeah.
B5.
No,
B5
is hanging.
Yeah.
B5 is hanging. Yeah.
Yeah, so knight
and after after bishop b4 I cannot take because of bishop a3.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't
have
to
special.
Go for this.
Yeah,
it's
one
of the
have
options.
So after b6 basically black was
fine.
Okay.
Okay, bishop b4 I was spending too much time and I just tried to find a way to swap some pieces.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you didn't seem too happy later when you took on a4, but you still understood that everything was under control and
I can cover my weaknesses. And the thing is that he doesn't have any clear plans, and in the long term, I'm okay. I can just shuffle the pieces around to go for knight e4 at some point, and then.
Yeah, I thought if I'm better, it's only very little. Yes. So mm-hmm. it didn't make sense to.
Yeah, so you decided to force the draw with rook takes d3, and then that was it. But a very deep game, and yeah, that was fun to actually comment on it also with
Vitor. Did you comment on Magnus' chippo, bishop f3, preparing knight d6 everywhere?
when I went back to f3.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, otherwise black is just winning after f5.
Ah, right.
But knight d6 is there, so.
Nice.
Very clever. Yes, yeah. Very clever.
Because of queen a2.
Yes,
that's
we have
to win. Yeah.
Just jump with on the board.
Mm-hmm.
And
finito.
That's not a cheapo, that's a beautiful trick.
Okay, thank you very
thank
much.
You very much.
Thanks.
So we are 15 minutes away from the time control, so it's high time to go back to the games which we've left because or thanks to this press conference with the two greatest players around nowadays. So we were looking at Anand against Nakamura. We were trying to discuss what's happening, and actually what's happening is the clock is ticking down.